In Lakshmi's grammar classes, I am going to teach you the topic, the simple, compound, complex, the compound complex sentences. A proper understanding of this topic enables you to speak and write English correctly. There are four kinds of sentences. The simple sentence, the compound sentence, the complex sentence, the compound complex sentence. Now look at the board. The simple sentence is very simple in structure. It contains a subject and a predicate. Look at this example. India won the match. As you know, the subject is the name of a person, place or a thing about whom or which something is said. Here, India is the subject. The remaining part of the sentence is called the predicate. A predicate must contain a verb. Here, the verb is won. A predicate may or may not contain an object. An object, as you know, is the name of a person, place or a thing affected by the action of the verb. Here, the object is the match. India won the match. India subject, one verb, the match is the object. Look at the next example. The bird flies. The bird is the subject. Flies is the predicate. Here, the predicate does not contain an object. The compound sentence contains two or more coordinate clauses. Coordinate clauses means clauses of equal rank connected by conjunctions. The compound sentence contains two or more coordinate clauses connected by conjunctions. Look at these examples. Eat to live, but do not live to eat. Here, this is a coordinate clause, eat to live. Do not live to eat is another coordinate clause. These two clauses are connected by the conjunction but. Look at the second example. Some are born great, some achieve greatness, and some have greatness thrust upon them. Here, there are three coordinate clauses. Some are born great, that is the first clause. Some achieve greatness, this is the second clause. Some have greatness thrust upon them, this is the third clause. All of these three clauses are coordinate clauses connected by the conjunctions and. Some are born great, here and is understood. Some achieve greatness and some have greatness thrust upon them. The complex sentence contains a main class and a subordinate class connected by a conjunction. In a complex sentence, there will be a main class. It stands upon itself. It doesn't depend upon any other part of the sentence. And a subordinate class. Subordinate class, it depends upon the main class. Look at the example. Gandhi said that his life was his message. Gandhi said is the main class. His life was his message, was the subordinate class. This class, subordinate class, is connected with the main class by the conjunction that. The compound complex sentence contains two or more coordinate clauses and at least one subordinate clause. The compound complex sentence should contain two or more coordinate clauses and at least one subordinate clause. Look at this sentence. Once, while Ishwar Chandra Vidyasagar was waiting on a railway platform, an Indian dressed in European style hailed him or called him as a coolie and ordered him to carry his luggage. Here, in this sentence, while Ishwar Chandra Vidyasagar was waiting on a railway station, this is the subordinate class. An Indian dressed in European style hailed him as a coolie. This is a coordinate class. Ordered him to carry his luggage. Another coordinate class. These two coordinate clauses are connected by the conjunction and. In a way, this is a compound sentence. And it is combined with the subordinate class. Once, while Ishwar Chandra Vidyasagar was waiting on a railway platform, this is the subordinate class. An Indian dressed in European style hailed him as a coolie. This is a coordinate class. Ordered him to carry his luggage. So this is a compound complex sentence. In the compound sentences, coordinating conjunctions and but, yet, or, for, so, nevertheless, whereas, either or, neither nor, not only but also, otherwise, or else, are used. These conjunctions are used in the compound sentences. Now I am going to give you some examples wherein the conjunctions are used correctly. They are very poor. yet they are honest. This is a compound sentence. He became old. Nevertheless, he continued to work. He is either a fool or a philosopher. He is either a fool or a philosopher. She is not only an actress, but also a very good singer. So these are some of the examples in which we have used these conjunctions correctly. In complex sentences, subordinating conjunctions that whether, if, since, before, after, though, although, as, when, where, why, what, how, as soon as, no sooner than, scarcely when, because, so that, till are useless. Now, I am going to give you some examples in which the conjunctions are used correctly. I don't know whether he liked it or not. Though he is rich, he never helps the poor. Though he is rich, he never helps the poor. No sooner had he reached the station than the train arrived. She sings because she gets pleasure. These are some of the examples wherein we use these conjunctions correctly. I hope you have understood whatever I taught you till now. In the next class, I am going to teach you how to convert a simple sentence, a complex sentence, a compound sentence, a compound complex sentences. These sentences, how to just convert them from one sentence to another sentence, I am going to teach you in the next class. Thank you.